welcome you to Laguna Tools, where we thrive on innovation. Today we're very excited to present to you a revolutionary way to build and assemble cabinets and improve all of your business processes. Over the next couple hours, you're going to hear how to automate your processes, improve your productivity, improve your profits, and what equipment it takes to make all that happen. We're joined by industry leaders from LockDowel, the innovator of this process, by Allmoxie for your front and back office automation, and Cabinet Vision, the best cabinet making software on the planet. They'll be also shown some Laguna Tools equipment. Again, the most innovative equipment that you could buy to put all this process together. Be followed up by a full demonstration. We're actually going to go through the process to show you how the assembly works, how the process is applied, and how we build a cabinet. So it's going to be fantastic. By the time you leave here today, you're going to have all the tools needed to lead your industry in profitability and productivity. The question will be, are you going to lead or are you going to fall behind?
Hey everybody, I'm Daniel Savage. I'm with LockDowel. I'm one of the engineers there that helped develop these products. And so this is, like you said, this is the LockDowel Laguna LD4. And it's like a doweling and insertion machine, but it's specially designed to insert LockDowel products, like the products Darren was showing you. It inserts the Eclipse products, the LockDowel channel lock, and also the H-clip product, as well as the steel spring pin that goes along with them. And it's a four-zone machine. It works together with the different softwares like Cabinet Vision. Cabinet Vision, you can do the design of your cabinets and output the drilling and insertion of the fasteners to this machine. There's also a parametric programming setup, so you can, you know, be running several different size cabinets, like if you're doing 12-inch uppers and 24-inch deep bases. You can use the same program and drill and insert the fasteners using this machine. It's got auto start features. It uses laser sensors to sense that there's a part in position. So you just slide the board in, have your parametric program set up, it'll automatically clamp, drill and insert the parts for you. And also, if you're doing barcoding, we have a wireless barcode scanner that, you know, as soon as you're ready to machine your part, you just scan the part, slide it in, it'll automatically select the zone and begin machining. So it's very simple, very easy to use. You just go to your work plane and drag and drop the programs that you have set up in there. So here I'm going to be using the channel lock parametric program. I'll insert a few fasteners into this test panel so you can see how it works. But basically you just drag and drop the program into the zones that you want to use. So I'm going to choose zone A. So you have four zones, zone A, B, C, and D. So I'm going to drag a program into zone A and to zone B, and that way I can machine two sides of this part. And they will be in the same position on each side. So it has a laser measuring tool to determine so the machine knows the length of the board, and the length determines how many fasteners the panel will receive. So as you can see here, after I insert the board and the laser measure begins to measure the panel before it inserts, you'll see this little graphic grow, and it'll actually give you a number readout on the screen what the actual length of the board is. So before you're ready to machine, if you're just gonna do one run, you uncheck the repeat selection. If you're gonna do multiple runs, you can leave that on and you can just keep running parts without having to touch the keyboard or the mouse. So as soon as you're ready to machine, just hit the start button. You probably heard it, maybe you didn't see it, but there's another zero divider here that pops up automatically up and down when you're using either of these two zones. If you're not using those zones, it'll stay flush with the work surface. Like if you're doing really tall cabinets with a full back and you're machining those tall backs, you can do those all in one shot and this will be out of your way. So when you're ready to machine, all you have to do is place the panel and flush it up against the stops. And after a few seconds, it'll automatically clamp down and begin running. So first it's going to come over and measure the part. So you can see the graphic brew there. Drilling the holes. And insert the E-clips. So you see there. Flip it around, do the mirrored side. Make sure your clamp's in the correct position. Now this part is ready to be installed on your cabinet. It's as easy as that.
Allmoxie was built using this idea of Industry 4.0, and I grew up in the woodworking industry. So we built Allmoxie specifically for a woodworking company. So the idea behind it is we give you an online ordering platform to where your customers can order automatically. And or order using a nice, easy system, and then it takes that information. It creates your parts list. It creates your exports. So later on, we're going to show you exporting out to Cabinet Vision. It can send invoices out automatically. It checks your supplies and orders all the supplies you need from your vendors. It's looking at, you know, employees are checking in and out of orders. It's updating the customer on where it is in the shop. All this is happening automatically just using a web-based system.
So first thing we're going to do is install our top and bottom panels, just setting them into place. And notice this one has a dado in it, and this one has a rabbeted edge. The bottom doesn't need the rabbeted edge because you're going to be able to slide the bottom panel in with this one locked into position. But this will be one of the last panels that you lock into position, and it'll cover the back panel, fully enclose it along with the nailer. You'll see that in a minute. But it just allows you access to getting the back panel in after you assemble the box with the sliding fastener. So notice we put these spring pins in this edge, and you can see the 8mm holes that match those in the top and the bottom. These, once you slide them into position after the box is built, will prevent all of the parts from sliding back and will keep the cabinet in a permanent fixed position once you mount it to the wall, screw it to the wall. So once you have all your parts set into place, it's got some dust. Line up the other end panel. Once it's all flush, you're ready to start sliding the parts into position. Start with the bottom panel, get that one all the way in, then you can stand it up. You got an open dado here, slide your back panel in. And Make sure that goes all the way down and sits into the dado at the bottom. Slide that in. And now your locking nailers will lock the tops and the bottom into place. Now the box is completely assembled. Put in your back panel fasteners. And again, these may not be 100% necessary for smaller cabinets, but when you go to larger, tall, like garage cabinets or kitchen cabinets where they get a little bit wobbly, these really come in handy. Special tool, that's the only tool you need. Piece of scrap. Now I got a really solid, sturdy cabinet, ready to be mounted.
Well, on behalf of Laguna Tools, I want to thank all of you for coming. I know that, again, it takes time away from your day, and hopefully we've added some value back to your day here. And I want to thank LockDowel for helping put everything together here, Cabinet Vision here, all Moxie. Again, these are industry partners that are pulling together to really kind of deliver good quality packages that make you guys profitable, that give you the return on investment for your time and for your equipment and for the rest of your business to go through and make you guys profitable and make you lean and mean. So we want to thank you all for being here today.
Thank you guys.